In this quick video, we're going to look at an important counting problem that is affectionately called the Stars and Bars problem. Here's the setup. Suppose that we had a collection of colored candies, and we want to make a bowl full of 7 candies, and we want to know all the different combinations of these colors that we can put in the new bowl. So here's the idea. The key to understanding how to do this counting is to understand a secret code called the Stars and Bars code. We'll do that in the following way. Since there were 3 colors that we were interested in, and we want to pick 7 candies, we're going to note that there was some yellow candies, there were some blue candies, and there were some red candies. Now we could pick 7 yellows and put them in the pile. We could put 7 reds or 7 blues or some combination of them to add up to a total of 7. So here's the idea. Let's set up a special code that we could tell what combinations we've got. I'm going to put 2 bars here. And then I'm going to put 7 stars. If I put the 7 stars here, then it would mean that I was putting 7 yellows, no blues, and no reds. So let's just look at that combination, that code. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, then a bar and a bar. So that means that we've got all yellows. Notice that I could give a code for all blues. I wouldn't put any in this first area. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. All blues and no reds. Of course, the code for all reds would be 2 bars. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And in fact, any combination can be made up with the Stars and Bars code. For example, we might want to have 3 yellows, 1 blue, and so now I've used up 4, so I've got to have 3 reds. Okay. So every possible combination of 7 candies here can be expressed as one of these Stars and Bars codes. Now notice that in each one of these codes, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 stars and 2 bars. So there's a total of 9 slots that we need to fill. In fact, to count up all of these different codes, which would be all the different combinations of candies, of 7 candies that we could make, we really need to fill in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 for the 7 candies, and 2 more marks for the bars. I just need to choose where to put the bars, and the rest will be stars, or else where to put the stars, and the rest will be bars. There'll be 2 bars and 7 stars. So the idea is that I need to find, out of those 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 stars and 2 bars, because there were 3 groups, out of the 9 slots, I need to pick 2 of them to be bars. Or, equivalently, out of the 9 slots, I need to pick 7 of them to be stars. Now you can quickly verify that both of these, of course, are equal, because the formula is 9 factorial all over 9 minus 2 would be 7 factorial times 2 factorial. In this case, it would be 9 factorial. All over 9 minus 7 would be 2 factorial times the 7 factorial. Okay, so the stars and bars is the way to do this. Now, you could look at a much more complicated problem. By complicated, I mean larger numbers. So suppose that there were 8 different colors. And we want to pick 12 candies. How many ways could this be done? Well, to get the 8 different colors, I would need 7 bars. Do you see why? Okay, up here, remember when we were doing 3 colors, we only needed 2 bars. Okay, now in this case, when we've got the 7 colors, when we've got the 8 different colors, we're only going to need 7 bars. We're going to need 12 stars. So the codes for this, I just need to count up how many different codes there are. There's going to be 19 different slots, and I need to pick 7 of them to be bars, or 19 different slots, and I need to pick 12 of them to be stars, because we're looking for 12 candies. Okay? And you can generalize the formula from there. Okay, that's the end of the video.